Hey YouTube, what's going on? Junior here, back again with another reaction video, back again with another viewer request, attempt two for today to put out a video, because as some of you saw earlier, I went through all the back-breaking effort of making one of these reaction videos for you guys, only for it to get taken down immediately. By the copyright demons. But such are the risks you take when you are the number one content creator on the internet. So you win some, you lose some. The nature of these reaction videos, some of them are gonna get taken down. I'm not gonna fight that. Makes sense. But you know which channel will never have a video get taken down? RuneGate Studio. You should all subscribe here for quality content and my other YouTube channel. Link will be in the description below. Let's get to the video. Today we're reacting to a band called The Black Queen, as requested by Dudamus Prime. The song we're doing, Ice to Never. I had never heard of The Black Queen before, but the name is intriguing. Sounds gothic, sounds dark, sounds romantic. I don't know. It caught my attention at least. But you know what, man? If I don't like this song, you don't even want to know what I'm going to do. Of course, everybody, following his example, leave your suggestions in the comments down below. The next video could be yours, which is pretty exciting. From the 80s or something? Nope. Okay. Got that aesthetic though. Alright. Boombox VHS grain. Okay, not the gothic symphonic metal epic I was expecting. It's off by a little bit. But, you know, some very nice 80s electronic vibes nonetheless. I love this aesthetic. The guy walking with the boombox, the grainy video effect silhouette, the colorful lights and everything. It's all very nice and it sounds very nostalgic. Whether or not that was their intention, that's what's going on. Yeah, okay, take a little off guard. Very fun, very calm and soothing right now. Very chill. The guy's voice is interesting. Had that vocal effect where it's simultaneously playing like octaves of his vocals as he's singing. So pretty cool. I first heard that on John Gom's Passion Flower song, if you haven't heard that before. But that's where I first got introduced to that effect. And it's pretty cool. Let's see what's going on in these lyrics. I tried to pretend I couldn't die for so long. I can't catch my bleeding heart for a song. I slept in a flame because it made me feel strong. Building up my ice to never thaw. Ice to never. I couldn't help myself. I've frozen all the doors. I didn't want you here, but a heartbeat reached for yours. This sounds like some sort of love song, post-breakup song, heartbreak tune, something or other, whatever, you know? Building up these walls of ice to, I guess, trap the feeling inside or to not allow the feeling inside to begin with. He's playing it tough. He's playing it cool. He's trying to pretend he couldn't die and he can't catch his bleeding heart to write a song. Okay, I see what's going on here. From what I'm getting here, it's kind of a relatable idea. I've probably said this before on some other love song or whatever, but this idea of being addicted to the pain and the feeling of utter heartbreak and devastation in order to, well, one, because it's just kind of an addicting state to be in, right? And two, because it fuels that creative fire. Except it seems that this guy can't catch his bleeding heart for a song, so maybe it's it's not working out so well for him. I couldn't help myself. I froze on the doors. I didn't want you here. So he's trying to isolate himself from this person. He's trying to shore up his defenses. However, whenever they enter his mind, their heartbeats reach out to each other. They connect. It's inevitable, and he can't find a way to stop it yet. Cool. Let's keep going. I'd like to think that that's just a random dude. So the vibe's staying pretty much the same. These visuals are pretty trippy and fun. I mean, overall, the song is not too crazy, not too complex. It's just like a good, chill vibe and time, which I'm okay with. You know, it's kind of late. Well, it's not really that late, but you know what? It's later than I usually make these videos, and I'm okay with just a chill song right now. Dude, it's Prime, you're lucky. You're lucky that I like this song, because you don't even want to know what would have happened. You're lucky. I thought that an I was so much less than a you. Blind devotion, never sees the things that you do. I slept in a flame to keep me open and true. Well, the first half of there is kind of detailing how while he was in this relationship, he valued the other person so much more than himself. And that, I guess, could be a contributing factor as to why the relationship fell apart. He kind of had that blind devotion, putting the other person up on a pedestal and not really seeing them as the flawed human being that, you know, everybody inevitably is. And then we have this little repeating part. I ran so far I didn't know it was me, but now there's nothing holding me here and nowhere else I'd rather go or be. So this person running away, trying to get away from this past relationship, has run so far that they no longer recognize themselves. They've, I guess, fallen down into this well of self-indulgence and apathetic despair, perhaps. But since that's where they've ended up and they've gotten used to it, there's nowhere else they'd rather be. That's a pretty dismal way of looking at this. I mean, it could be something else. He could just be trying to just run it away and trying to transform himself as a person. It doesn't have to always be so sad. Sometimes life is just sad. Oh, look at this homie. I really want to believe that this is just a random dude on the street. And I'm going to believe it even if it's not true. Oh, where's it going? Oh, that's a decently sized wave, actually. Boom. We were in Tron the whole time. Okay. Alright. So that was the Black Queen, Ice to Never. Needless to say, not what I expected at all, but a very fun time nonetheless. It was this vintage, nostalgic, 80s era, like, electronic pop tune. That was just, it was just fun. It was just a fun time. The lyrics, nothing crazy, and as far as I can see, just like a love song. A song about, well, kind of, like a song about dealing with the aftermaths of being in love and it not working out, which is just a classic, timeless subject for all art in general. Yeah, I mean, there's not too much I can say about it. I just wanted to have a nice, fun, quick video for something today, you know, something I could just put out so you guys could have some sort of high-quality content on the internet somewhere today. So, I'm just doing my civic duties. And what can I say? I love the aesthetic. I love the fun, funky sound. It was very vintage. It was very old school. And I like the bright colors too. You know, not everything that I listen to or enjoy has to be despairing or dark or plague-ridden and corpse-strewn battlefields and black eyeliner and corpse paint, you know? I can enjoy some fun neon synthy stuff every once in a while. And that's it. That's all. That's the message, you know? Have a broad music taste and life will just be better because you can just enjoy everything that comes your way. And that's all I'm going to say for today. So thanks for watching the video, guys. If you liked it, make sure to like it. If you like me, make sure to subscribe. Of course, everybody have a great day. I'll see you on Thursday, as I said before, on my little community post. Yeah. Hopefully this video doesn't get taken down. Ha ha!